So let me start with Najla. Najla, could you read this question? Najla?
What happens to the price of a good if a shortage exists in the market?
Yes, go ahead. Enhance. Najla?
Enhance your answer by a practical example using the graph below.
Okay, so shortly, because already I explained this. So at 175, this is a practical when I say 175. The price, the quantity demanded of tomatoes will be 50. The quantity supplied will be 25. Customers will compete to buy first. That will lead to upward pressure on the price. As the price increases, quantity supplied will increase while quantity demanded will increase. If there is still shortage, the upward pressure on the price will continue till we reach equilibrium. At 250, the quantity demanded equals a quantity supplied and the market will be stable. So I'm still with Najla. Could you read this question? Najla?
What happens to the price of a good if a surplus exists in the market?
Enhance?
Enhance your answer by a practical example using the graph below.
Okay, so assume we started with the price 3 dirhams. The quantity supplied exceeds quantity demanded, which is excess supply or surplus. So that will lead to downward pressure on the price. As the price decreases, quantity demanded increases while quantity supplied decreases. If there is still surplus, the downward pressure will continue till we reach equilibrium price. At 250, quantity demanded equals the quantity supplied. Okay, so this question, why demand curve intersects both axes? So at price of 32, the quantity demanded will be zero because of limited income. Why the demand curve intersects a quantity axis? If the price zero, the customer will take in only 30 units because basically because of limited time. I cannot consume more than 80 units per week. And the marginal utility of the additional unit will be zero. There is no benefit. So I can wait for next week and take other 30 units. I remember we explained this. This question, Najla, can you read this question? Najla? Muhammad Abdul Wahab.
هلا دكتور.
Read the question as consumer.
As consumer, incomes have risen and tastes and preferences improve. There is a growing for demand for very large vehicles. What effect has this had on the price of gasoline?
Okay, see here. Try to analyze the information. Demand for large vehicles increased. Demand for large vehicles increase. What effect has this had on the price of gasoline? So if the demand for vehicles increases, demand for gasoline will increase. So it draw intersection between demand and supply curve. And then draw a new demand curve because the demand for gasoline will increase. Draw a new demand curve. And you will see there will be an increase in equilibrium price of gasoline and increase in equilibrium quantity of gasoline. So again, If demand for large vehicles increases, demand for gasoline also will increase. As demand for gasoline increases, the equilibrium price of gasoline will increase. Equilibrium quantity of gasoline will increase. This is the answer. Muhammad Abdul Wahab, next question.
Explain the factors that could cause a decrease in the supply of a product.
Okay, see here, a decrease in the supply of a product means the supply curve will shift to the left, a decrease in supply. Which factor? Number one, an increase in production cost. And the increase in the production cost may cause by increase in the price of labor, which is increase in wages, or increase in the rent, this is the price of land, or increase in the capital, which is increase in interest rate. Or the price of a related goods, such as price of onion, increases, supply for tomatoes will decrease. So this question above, what is the difference between a change in quantity demanded and a change in demand? I explained this question in details, but shortly, a change in quantity demanded is a movement along the demand curve and is caused by a change in the price of the product itself. A change in demand means a shift of the entire demand curve, and it is caused by a change in one of other factors, such as income, prices of related goods, tastes or preferences, expectations. The last question, Muhammad Abdul Wahab, last question in blue, assuming
that Hamad aims to maximize profits, his farm's decision about what quantity of potatoes to supply depends on some factors. List these factors.
Okay, so shortly, without details, number one, the price per kilo of potatoes. Number two, production cost. In return, depends on the prices of inputs and technologies. Number three, prices of related goods. For example, assume Ubaid produces potatoes and tomatoes. So we finish from this. Let me go to something else. So I will finish soon, don't feel upset. So in LMS, there is a file called calculations. If you go to calculation, let's start with the demand and supply. So here we have some questions. So this question is nice. So if you remember, we have information about equation of demand and supply. Find the equilibrium price and equilibrium quantity. Sorry. So as we explain in the class, equality between quantity demand and quantity supplied. The equilibrium price 10 and the equilibrium quantity will be 800. Okay, let's read C. Muhammad Abdul Wahab, can you read C?
If the price in the market is $12, would the market be at equilibrium? If not, is there a shortage or surplus? How large is the shortage or surplus?
Okay, so now the key is 12. So see here, the answer, since the market price is 10, so at 12, the market will be at disequilibrium, not equilibrium, disequilibrium. Since the price is 12 above than the equilibrium price, we will have surplus. Okay, how much is the surplus? Substitute 12 in the equation of quantity supplied and substitute 12 in the equation of quantity demanded. So quantity supplied 860, quantity demanded 760. Calculate the difference between them is 100. So surplus is 100. But if the price 8 dirhams. So we will not be at equilibrium, we will be at disequilibrium, because the price is less than equilibrium price of 10. Since the price is lower than equilibrium, we will have shortage. So again, substitute 8 for both equations and calculate. Find the difference between them. You will find the shortage is 100. So I think this question is quite easy and interesting. And this is the same question, but I change the numbers. So it's not necessary to read all this information. Abdul Wahab, read the question 3.3.
The figure below shows the market for cotton fabric, in which D stands for demand curve and S stands for supply curve.
Okay, so now we have information about demand and supply. So if the price is 16, this is 16, would be the market at equilibrium? The answer is no. If there is a shortage or surplus, so equilibrium price is 12. So at 16, a quantity supplied exceeds quantity demanded. So there will be surplus. If the price above than equilibrium price, we will have surplus. How large is the surplus? So at 16, read the quantity supplied, it is 160. The quantity demanded 80. The difference between them is 80. So the surplus is 80. Muhammad Abdul Wahab, read B.
If the price in the market is 12, would the market be at equilibrium? If not, is there a shortage or surplus? How large is the shortage?
Okay, so at 12, the quantity demanded equals the quantity supplied, which is 120. There will be no shortage, no surplus. The shortage or surplus will be zero. So let's go to Abdurrahman C. Muhammad Abdul Wahab, C.
If the price in the market is 10, would the market be at equilibrium? If not, is there a shortage or surplus? And how large is the shortage?
See here, at 10, since 10 is less than equilibrium price, we will have shortage because quantity demanded 140 and the quantity supplied 100. So the shortage will be 40. So, and you can see the answer is here. I wrote the answer already. This is last question for today. So Muhammad Abdul Wahab will help me. So the figure below shows the market for cotton fabric. Muhammad Abdul Wahab, A.
According to panel A, explain the effect of a change in demand or supply on the equilibrium price and quantity.
Okay, so look at panel A. What happened? Demand increases. So what will compare between initial equilibrium point and the new equilibrium point? So equilibrium price increases, equilibrium quantity increases. Let's go to B.
Explain the effect of a change in demand or supply on the equilibrium price and quantity.
Okay, so this dot, I think it's clear by the graph. This dot is the initial equilibrium point. What happened? Supply increases. This is a new equilibrium point. So what happened to equilibrium price? Equilibrium price decreases while equilibrium quantity increases. Hopefully you can read the information. So that's enough for this question. Let's go to another case. We will read. So number A, Muhammad Abdul Wahab.
According to graph 5, explain what happens to the supply and demand curves and demonstrate the effects on equilibrium price and quantity.
Okay, so maybe this is a bit more advanced. Let's go to graph number 5. This is graph number 5. Do you know, just I need you to read the information. So S1 with D1, so this dot refers to initial equilibrium point. What happened? Supply increases. So supply curve shifts to the right. This is an increase in supply, while demand decreases because demand curve shifts to the left. What happened to equilibrium price? This is a new equilibrium point between D2 and S2. So equilibrium price decreases while the quantity, there is no change in equilibrium quantity. Why? Because the increase in supply is equivalent to decrease in demand. So only the price decreases while there is no change in the equilibrium quantity. So Muhammad Abdul Wahab, B.
According to graph 6, explain what happens to the demand and supply curves and demonstrate the effects on equilibrium price and quantity.
Okay, so this file is in LMS. You can go to LMS and check the information. So see here, look at S1 and D1. S1 and D1. So this is the initial equilibrium point. What happened? Supply decreases. Please don't get confused. If supply curve goes to the left, this is a decrease in supply. And demand curve also decreases because demand curve shifts to the left. Where is the new equilibrium point? This is the new equilibrium point between D2 and S2. What happened to equilibrium price? There is no change in equilibrium price, while equilibrium quantity decreases.